Sometimes, your app needs to save important data on the device. If it's structured data, chances are you want to use a SQL database. And a SQL database engine that is available on almost any device, including mobile phones, is called SQLite. It's small and self-contained. It uses a single file to store your tables, and the code is public domain. Flutter developers have a variety of options for using SQLite. One of the most popular plugins is sqflite. In sqflite, you open a database file by calling OpenDatabase. Almost everything in sqflite is asynchronous, so you'll have to await. You can also provide callbacks that create the database if it doesn't exist yet, or upgrade the database if it's using an old schema. SQLite lets you execute raw SQL on the database, and it helps you with escaping values so you don't accidentally corrupt your database. You can also use higher level functions, insert, update, delete, to modify your database, and query to get data out of it. SQLite also supports transactions and batching, so your database operations can be safer and more efficient. Lastly, a couple of tips from the community. It's best to design your database and test your queries on your development machine and only then copy your SQL to your project. If you use foreign keys, you can enable them in onConfigure when opening the database. Foreign keys are not on by default. Don't forget that sqflite is not your only local database option. Research pub.dev to see if there's a local database plugin that fits your needs better. For more details and instructions on including this functionality in your app, check out the sqflite package on pub.dev.